Hello, my name is Horatiu Crișan. I am assistant professor at University Iuliu Hațeganu in Cluj-Napoca, Faculty of Medicine, chair of Abilities and Human Sciences. I will be presenting you today some aspects of contemporary and traditional Romanian culture. This is also an optional course that you will be able to choose during your first year here in Cluj. We'll also meet during another course, the course of medical bioethics. So today I will give you some details about Romanians and Romania, about the words Romanians and Romania. And I will give you some examples about traditional culture, Romanian traditional culture, Romanian modern culture, and of course, Romanian contemporary culture. I will end with some cultural commonplaces, things that everybody knows, that all Romanian knows, and then you should also, and I'm sure you will also know them shortly after you will come to Cluj. Why are Romanians special? Why are Romanians special in this part of the world, in this part of Europe? They are special because they are the only ones who speak a Romance language, a Latin-based language. And the name Romanians, also Romanian and Romanians, also come from Latin, Romanus in Latin. Român was the older form, and Român, the term used in the modern Romanian language. There was another name used for Român starting with the 10th century, Vlach or Valach. Those who speak Latin was the translation, and this was the name given to us by other people, living. Living in Europe, those who speak Latin. Romania, the name of the country. We have Romania as an official name for not for the country as you know it today, with the borders known today, but from 1862 to 1866 it was Valachia. It was called Țara Românească, because it was called, one part of it was called Țara Românească and the other part Moldova, and when they unified, the name for them was Romania, of course, without Transylvania. We have Transylvania together with Romania. We have it only in 1918, so a little more than 100 years. And in 1918 was the unification of Transylvania with Romania, with Țara Românească and Moldova. And during the Second World War, we had the Greater Romania, the Great Romania, Romania Mare. And after the Second World War, following the Paris Peace Conference, we have the actual borders. And you may know that there is also a country called Moldova, and this is beyond the River Prut. It's also they also speak Romanian, and formerly it was part of Romania. We also have Moldova as a province of Romania, let's say, as a part of Romania. I will tell you now more about the customs and the objects of art that are related to traditional, modern, and contemporary Romanian culture. Of course, most of the customs, like in your countries where you come from, or in your cultures when you come from, are related to birth, to death, to marriage, to baptism, to different types of religious holidays, the relationship with nature, the relationship of human beings with the others. I will tell you more about the ones who are already well known, because they are part of the Intangible Cultural Heritage of Humanity, the UNESCO Intangible Cultural Heritage of Humanity. These are the customs or the rituals who got recorded as part of the universal heritage of humanity. Kalush, the Kalush ritual, this is a dance, but it's also a ritual, an initiation ritual. We have the doina, which is a type of singing and not only a song, a type of singing from the throat. We have the Horezu ceramics, the kolindat, the caroling. It's sort of a caroling, but specific for our culture. And we have the let's dances. This is a specific type of dance that we only find in certain villages. Now, passing to arts and crafts, these are objects. This is about material, tangible culture. And they witness a long time the elements which are essential for the Romanian culture. We have these sites, archaeological sites related to ancient history. We have also a lot of buildings related to Orthodox religion. And we have not only Orthodox, but most of them are related to Orthodox. We also have sites which have a religious but also historical function, and we have many sites, medieval sites in Transylvania, which are a sort of a proof of our multi-ethnic cohabitation here in Transylvania. I will begin with the older ones, the Dacian fortresses of the Oroștie Mountains. These are archaeological sites related to the population who inhabited the north of Danube before the and also after the conquest by the Roman Emperor Traian of these territories. The Dacians were the local population, and the Romanian people was formed by their cohabitation. After the conquest of Traian, they cohabitated, the colonies, the Roman colonies cohabitated with the local population called the Dacians. And of course, the name of the of these territories north of Danube was called Dacia, no? Dacia Felix by the Romans. And this is an important name. You also know about the name of the car company, Dacia. Then we have the wooden church of Maramureș. Maramureș is an area near the border with Ukraine, north of Cluj. We have these villages in which you find the traditional churches, the wooden churches. These are small churches made only of wood. And inside you have old paintings or religious paintings. You can also see them closer to us, closer, I mean, in Cluj. You can see them in the village museum on the Hoya Hill. You can see these churches. They are restored, and you can see them here in Cluj. Then you have the, maybe some of you already heard about them. These are the monasteries of Moldavia. Moldavia here is understood as a part of Romania, the northeastern part. These are the name of the monasteries and the name of the villages, or the name of the villages near which the monasteries were built. What is interesting and unique about these churches of monasteries is that they are painted on the outside. And in Cluj, if you look at all the churches, you will never see a church painted on the outside. We have icons inside the church always, in Orthodox churches, in Catholic churches, and in Greek Catholic churches. We only have them inside the churches. But here you have these religious paintings that describe the main events, the biblical events, which describe it, you have it outside the church, on the wall of the church of the monastery. We have another monastery which is very important in our culture, Monastery of Horezu. This is south of Carpathians. And we have other buildings which have a religious nature, is the village, the fortified churches in Transylvania. Of course, they are not Orthodox. They are Protestant, and we have these churches in some villages in Transylvania which have been restored through different international projects. And you could also visit the villages and these fortified churches. And of course, another medieval site, it's the Sighișoara city center, historic center of Sighișoara. This is the birthplace of Vlad Țepeș, who was also known as Dracula. He was born here in Sighișoara, although he was never a king of Transylvania, but only a king of Valahia, so south of Carpathians. I will give you now an example to see the becoming of a household entrance gate, to see how this changes from traditional culture to contemporary, to modern and contemporary culture. To see this object, in a way an object of art, to see it throughout time. This is the traditional entrance gate from households in Maramureș and Bukovina. You can see it even nowadays if you go there through the villages. These are nicely decorated and are difficult to craft because they are made by hand. Of course, less and less craftsmen are there, live there. This craftsmanship, of course, is going to die because young people are not interested in learning this craft. But you can still see the gates, and this is the traditional gate with different motifs. You have the tree of life, you have the sun, you have the moon. So different religious or traditional motifs. Then you have the sort of a modern interpretation by a famous Romanian, let's say French-Romanian or Romanian-French sculpture. It's Constantin Brâncuș. Very important for the history of modern sculpture. It's the Poarta Sărutului, the Gate of the Kiss. It's in Târgu Jiu. This was created in 1938. We also have the contemporary artist from Cluj who actually worked also in Cluj as an artist and then in France. It's Mircea Cantor's Arch of Triumph. This was exposed in 2008 in Paris at an exhibition. It makes reference to the old gates and also to the modern one built by Constantin Brâncuș. But the difference is that it's not the Tree of Life, which is it's not the motif of the Tree of Life, but it's the DNA, which stands on the as a motif on the gate. Is the DNA, and you know, at the base it's a human being. So we don't have the religious motif and symbols, but we have the, let's say, the scientific and the, you know, self-reference to man. In a sort of a scheme, in passing from traditional to modern and contemporary culture, a lot of things change. Traditional culture is rural, conservative, and religious. The community, the family is important, the community of the village is important, whereas After the arrival of communism, this changes. Of course, communism means also modernity, a form of modernity, because communists, after the Second World War, as you know, Romania was ruled by the Communist Party. We have forced urbanization, we have the attempt to create a new man in a society based on production and not on consumption, as you are acquainted with. We pass from religion to ideology, and we pass from from a family-based society to a collectivist, let's say, collectivist society in which the society is the most important thing and not the individual. Of course, after the Romanian Revolution and with the political changes that took place in Eastern Europe, not only in Romania, in Central and Eastern Europe, and we have also urban culture, but not forced. Now everybody wants to come to cities, to the big cities, because they want to. It's not the state who is forcing them. We have, of course, a different liberal and consumerist culture. The power of religion is maybe less and less important, because it's in a way it's a secularized, more secularized society than the traditional one, and the individual is the most important thing. I will end with some cultural commonplaces, things that you will learn for sure, words that you will get the meaning of. I chose 9 cultural commonplaces. I already mentioned communism. This is very important in Romanian culture. Then we have the Casa Poporului. It's a huge building. It's the second largest building in the world after the Pentagon in Bucharest. It was the house of the people, but instead, of course, during communism, it was not the people who, the Romanian people who lived in it, but the party officials. Nowadays, it's the parliament who is, of course, other institutions, but also the parliament who is using the people's house. We also have a sculpture by Constantin Brâncuș, very well known in Romanian, in our culture. It's the Infinite Column. It's also in Târgu Jiu, and you can visit Târgu Jiu and see these sculptures by Constantin Brâncuș. We also have Nadia Comăneci. This is a famous Romanian gymnast, the first one in the world to get a perfect 10 at the Olympics. Then we have Vlad Țepeș, also known as Dracula. I already told about him. He was born in Sighișoara, but was never king of Transylvania. We have Mărțișoru, and this is a sort of a gift given by men of all ages to women of all ages with the arrival of spring. This happens at the beginning of March, all these customs related to the Mărțișor. And if you will be walking through Cluj, through the center of Cluj at the beginning of March, you will notice this custom. I end with important things related to food culture, to Mici Sarmale and the slaughtering of the pig. Here in Romania we like pork, and we in the villages they also slaughter the pig the traditional way in order to produce what? To produce traditional dishes like sarmale, or to produce mici, which is another dish that you may try, especially during summer. So with these cultural commonplaces, I will end my presentation. I thank you for your patience, and I will be seeing you during the first semester at our university. Thank you. Bye.